So we travel over to the Nara and the Akita prefectures and study the Japanese drumming over there, and then we bring it back to the United States. That was the demonstration that we just gave.
When did this begin? When did this origin come from?
So the original, so taiko, the word taiko just means drum. So the original taiko drum was in Buddhist temples, and they would strike it once per year. It went on with that for centuries and centuries. And then in the 1960s, people from Japan were playing kabuki theater, which is played with one drum only, the small shimmy drum down there. They will play that drum while another person does theater. And one of the drummers for that came to the United States and actually fell in love with jazz music and said, why can't I recreate this in Japanese culture using the drums that I play? And he took jazz music from the United States back to Japan. And hence, Kume Daiko, which is what we were playing today, was born. There's no one else. So, in the seated position, straight up and down. It's important because they celebrate everything. They have festivals for everything. And the drumming is used in the festivals to help them celebrate. So everything we do, the first song is a meditation song. The second song is a war song. The third song was festival. So there's all sorts of different emotions, and they're all about celebrating those emotions and performing for those festivals.
Thank you very much.
Hey, thank you. Love it.
Thank you. is, it's a native plant and it flowers year-round continuously. And then these we still see in, this is the most common one in Broward County. There's an example of the one in bloom there.
Wow. Okay, I've seen that.
Louisiana, Tampa. And you still see that in all the old oak trees, any place, old neighborhoods, like on the ridges, Coral Ridge, or any place like that where they have a lot of old oak trees.
Right.
You see those plants up there. This guy here.
Oh, yeah.
Another cyclia. So a lot of them have fragrances here.
These are spectacular.
This is Jamaica. So this is a Jamaican species from Tony Sanguinea. And this is what, this is shows you how the babies, these are little baby ones of these.
Oh, wow.
So there's about 25 orchids in here.
That's wild.
This is, this is called a community pot.
Oh, my
And
God.
They line up the little, they grow them in flasks in sterile environments, and then they kind of line them up in these pots. Grow them like this for about a year before they get broken out. So this turns into this. This is a this plus 3 years equals this.
Wow.
So it kind of takes a long time. That's why they're a little bit expensive. It takes so long.